Alrighty, folks, as one rental at a time channel grows in influence, I'm getting the opportunity to look at new technologies and new solutions. And we have Griffin and Stone from SimpliLeads that I think offers an interesting option for real estate investors. Griffin, Stone, how you guys doing?
Doing well. Doing well. Thanks, Michael.
Great.
Awesome, buddy. Well, Griffin, I think you've been watching One Rental at a Time for a little bit of time, so you get the honor of going first. Tell us a little bit about yourself and a little bit about the company.
Of course. Yeah. So just briefly on myself, I got into real estate just over about, 2 or 3 years ago, started on the sales side. So, got the real estate license and, was hitting the pavement doing that type of work. And on the side also working with a larger agent and real estate investor, kind of running his operations and a lot of front end, back end stuff. And, really caught a bug for, not so much the sales, but the real estate investing aspect of it.
Yeah. And you can go ahead and say his name. Benny's been on the channel a couple of times. Benny Clay out in Fresno.
Yes.
Obviously was a partner with Jason Pritchard, who's been on my channel as a weekly guest. So lots of people know Benny. So that's who you were working with, right? Do I remember that story correctly?
Yes, that's exactly right. And Jason, I actually started working, directly with Jason. He was really the one who got me into it. When him and Benny were kind of working together as a group. And then when they kind of went to do their own thing, Benny needed, a full-time operations manager and I became his guy. So.
Very, very cool. Well, Stone, tell us about yourself. What do you do in this crazy world? And we'll get into what you guys provide.
Yeah, absolutely. So kind of briefly on myself, I focus more on the investment side of things. I actually got my real estate license as well. And I ended up meeting Griffin through Benny. So I worked at the same Keller Williams office as them and started kind of working underneath Benny a little bit more on the investment side of things, focused on some of the multifamily space. And that's where I met Griffin. And then we started this journey together. I've been primarily focused on the commercial side of things. So commercial, industrial buildings, retail spaces, things like that. And I've just been going from there.
I think there's a lot of opportunity. I think one of the things we're going to see in this cycle is the pain/opportunity is not so much in residential, but definitely will be on the commercial side with all this bridge debt, short-term debt, refi debt. So it'll be interesting to see what you guys provide in that space as well. So why don't we talk about the company you guys built? You launched something called SimpliLeads. Kind of tell us what it is. And also let's highlight the avatar, kind of the target audience for it.
Of course. Yeah. So, in a nutshell, we are a direct to seller SMS marketing and lead generation company for real estate investors specifically. We provide everything from, skip tracing investors lists, marketing out to those prospects, getting that initial touch, that initial outreach, and then setting up, warm phone call or in-person appointments for these investors to go and, follow up with the lead, continue that conversation and hopefully close the deal in the end. So,
yeah. So again, I don't pretend to play in this space. So I just have some questions. Again, I've been in the game a long time, but I know there are some, I'm going to call them challenges. I don't know what else to call them around texting, right? Whether it be with, I think it's with carriers about what blast text or again, I'm not going to pretend to know what it is, but I have friends in the industry that are like always frustrated with the rules seemingly changing. I'm going to guess this is not news to you and you probably have a solution or something around that, but I hear it's not as easy as some people make it out to be. What do you guys got going on here?
Of course. I mean, you're exactly right. There are a ton of challenges, just like with any other sort of, direct to seller type of marketing. You touched on the blast texting. That's something that the carriers, sending out, clicking one button and sending out 500, 1,000 messages all at once. That's something that's been heavily cracked down on. And in order to stay on top of that, we only use per-click send platforms. So, one click is one send. So that gets around, the blast texting restrictions of it as well. And you also touched on the carriers. That's a big thing that, that we're always kind of, head to head against. They have released something called a 10DLC registration, a 10-digit long code is kind of how they categorize the online application-based phone numbers that we use to reach out to prospects.
Okay.
And so, you know, in order to stay ahead of that, and on top of that, we register our business and our use case with that 10DLC entity. And, you know, we kind of, you know, we play by its rules in a way, and, you know, just keeping that reputation, keeping that credibility, linking our business, to our use case really keeps us ahead of the curve on that.
Well, Stone, let me come to you with this question. Who's the avatar, right? When you guys are in the business on the street looking for deals, you know, working with Jason or Benny or like folks, and then you go off and you're going to develop a technology. Who is the avatar, right? Who should be looking at this? And by that, who shouldn't be looking at this?
Yeah. So, you know, kind of to touch on that, really, really this is built for pretty much any investor out there. We want to bring in newer investors into the space who are just trying to get started, just trying to find their first initial deals, rather than going to like a wholesaler or, you know, trying to go the typical find your property on Zillow route, which, you know, a lot of people push out there. Or, you know, some of the guys who've been in this space a long time, such as yourself, who are more established and are looking to kind of build more of the technological side into their, you know, their applications that they're doing right now, and just kind of adding on to their business rather than, you know, having to redesign anything. You know, we integrate directly with your CRMs, you know, all of that sort of thing. So you don't have to change anything. We really try and make it as easy as possible on you. That's the one thing we really learned from, you know, working with Benny and working with some other folks. You know, investors want things to be able to focus on, you know, the things that are going to make them money versus the things that are, you know, just the day-to-day stuff. So we like to handle all the day-to-day stuff, integrations and all that. So you can just focus on doing what you guys do best.
Yeah. So one of the things that when I'm hearing this conversation, I'm thinking about it, and I mean this as a compliment, but you may not take it that way, is what you're trying to provide with SimpliLeads is kind of the picks and shovels, right? You're trying to be that platform to go out there. Mm-hmm. But where I mean by the picks and shovels is you still need the investor to build the list, right? One of the things I did over the weekend is have a legend of real estate event. And one of those legends is April Crosley. She buys almost all of her deals off market. And she's focused on small multifamily being kind of the 5 to 20 unit buildings. So what does April do? She goes out, she leverages PropStream and other lead or other, I don't know. She called them lead stacking, you know, kind of list stacking.
Mm-hmm.
And then I, you know, once she has that and she's done that work, then she could come to someone like you and you're just executing it being the picks and shovel. Is that fair?
Certainly. Yeah. Yeah. So we, you know, we allow the investor to, you know, really target the both the property type and the area that they, you know, want to invest in. And then, yeah, we are all of the front end work, you know, we're all the, you know, the groundwork and actually getting those, that, you know, those touches.
But you're not building the list. You're operating on a list.
Correct.
Got it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So again, that's one of the things that I think is very important for investors to realize is, again, that's what I meant by picks and shovels, right? You guys are doing the work after the investor has built the list. And that's what April was telling us is people need to get really focused. And this is just what she shared. So it's already out there, right? So she comes from healthcare. So what did she do? So she went out first and got a list from PropStream about all the small multifamily, easy to do. Then she went out and found, I don't know, some kind of doctor repository, whatever that is. And she's like, okay, who are the doctor, right? Who's a doctor that happens to own one? So she took this big list. She got it down to kind of her avatar being someone in the healthcare industry. And she sent very targeted mailing. Think about it, right? Hi, I'm a buyer. I was in the healthcare industry for so and so long. You know, think about that. Even that, she does mailers, but think how about that could be a text as well, right? Fellow healthcare worker. You know, just think about how you can just tailor that. So I think a lot of people need to focus on the list because the time of shotgun lists where you just buy a, you know, 1,000 this and you just send it out, that's probably wasting money because the easy deals are done already, I think.
Right. Right. And just like, you know, how she, you know, based on who she's trying to reach out to, her message is tailored. So, you know, hi,
exactly.
You know, healthcare worker, you know, and that's another thing that we bring that we take off the investor's plate. You know, they let us know the criteria. And then for their campaign, the messages that are going out to those prospects are going to be tailored specifically to what they're looking for. You know, whether they're looking for, you know, looking at, you know, code enforcement or, you know, bankruptcy, lien properties, things like that. You know, you come at it with a different approach, you know, versus maybe like a, you know, multifamily, larger commercial building. The wording is going to be different, and it's going to be specific to the people that they're talking to and the properties they're looking for.
So we didn't plan this ahead of time. Do you want to share your screen and show the application or show the website or tell people where they can go to get this? You guys have your computer open. You want to do that?
Yeah, I can open the website. Certainly, I can pull that up. And
I know we didn't plan for this. I guess I should have said that, but
no, that's all right.
Yeah. Okay. Real time. Yeah. Why don't you show it? Because again, folks, if this interests you, again, you should go take a look at it, see if it fits your business, your model. But I thought it was interesting enough to bring to the channel. So
let me share it here and see, kind of show you what people would be looking at when they log on to the site.
Let's show. There we go. We can see it.
There it is. Great. So yeah, this is our homepage. You know, lead generation simplified. Here's our brand, you know, direct to seller marketing, specialized in providing investors with off-market real estate leads.
Okay.
And so essentially you'll scroll down to the how it works section and kind of a simple three-step from the, you know, the moment you log onto the website to the moment that you can start receiving leads.
Okay.
You know, you'll schedule a meeting with us. We'll figure out, you know, what your investment experience is, what your goals are moving forward. That kind of helps us target a campaign specifically to you and your goals. Mm-hmm. And then there's that prepare your list section. So that is, you know, the very initial thing that is on the investor, like you said, you know, to get their criteria down, get their list built, choosing areas, property types they'd like to invest in. And then we handle the skip tracing. So we handle getting accurate cell phone numbers for the prospects in their list. Okay. So that we make sure that the texting is fruitful.
Okay.
After that, you know, we're going to, like Stone mentioned, we log into all of your existing systems. We just plug right in. And so once we start, you know, getting to touch with the motivated seller, we have that initial conversation. And then at the end of it, we set up a, you know, a phone call appointment for the investor to follow up. They have access to the entire conversation, something that's a little different with cold calling, unless the conversation is recorded and, you know, the investor can listen through. You really don't know what was said other than, you know, your cold caller's notes that they took.
Because you're capturing the whole text stream or whatever we call that.
Right. So you can see just as you would on, you know, on your cell phone, the back and forth, exactly how it went. So you're fully caught up. It's a much warmer phone call than it would be just, you know, picking up the phone and dialing to a prospect right away. So.
Yeah. The other thing I just want to talk about here, lead source, again, just going back to past conversations I've had. And again, just give a shout out to April. She actually raises private money. So no, we're talking about lists here being residential or commercial, but if somebody wanted to go out and go to title and figure out who the private lenders are, right, that's public data.
Mm-hmm.
That could very easily be another list source that you create, and then you have a targeted message. Say, hey, I saw you, you know, you're a first deed of trust on, you know, so-and-so property. You know, I'm an investor in the market. Let's have coffee or whatever, right? So there's other lists you could create and use what I'm calling picks and shovels, for, again, lack of a better term. That's pretty cool. Okay.
Yeah. And let's say, you know, an investor has, you know, more of the lead generation part of it down. And what they're really looking at is disposition, right? Like an investor is tasked with building a buyer's list. You know, they could do something like, you know, log on to their MLS, pull up the properties within the last year or two that have been bought all cash.
Right.
And, you know, more than likely that's, you know, they're going to be an investor, or at least an agent who, you know, you can find the agent who deals with investor type buyers.
Yep.
And you can send messages that are tailored directly to them. You know, hey, fellow investor. You know, I'm locking up deals constantly every month. I want you to be on a buyer's list. Send me your email and you can get off-market deals sent directly to you. So those type of lists can be built as well. So,
okay. Interesting. So really it's about what are you looking to find? What's kind of, again, we're just calling it a list here. What's your target? And then you're automating, basically filtering through that list, however long it is, and then just only providing the quality lead at the end. That's what you're trying to get to.
Yes. Yep. Eliminate all of the digging and the actual legwork for the investor so that they can focus on, you know, only calling the warm leads and working their magic, closing those deals. So,
okay. I get it. All right.
Yeah. And you know, this section, you know, it just sort of touches on, you know, why we chose SMS messaging over, you know, the other mediums, you know, primarily cold calling and direct mail. You know, with a cold call, you know, it's a very synchronous form of communication. So the caller and the person picking up the phone, you know, they both need to be ready and willing to answer the phone call at that time, or, you know, the touch is completely missed. You know, and even just, you know, personal experience, people are answering phone calls from unknown numbers less and less every single month,
I do not. My phone doesn't even recognize those numbers. It just goes right to voicemail. Yeah,
exactly. And you know, they, you know, a lot of cold, they might leave a voicemail, they might not, you know, and the touch is more or less missed. Right. With texting, you know, that's not the case, right? Not only does the prospect not need to be ready, they can view the text at any time, but they really, no matter what, will read your entire message. You know, your message will get to them. They don't have to stay on the phone for the whole seconds for you to get your whole pitch in. You know, they see it, they read it, and they can come back to it at any time. You know, just yesterday, we got a message back from a prospect that for one of our investors, the last message that we sent to him was February 1st. And, you know, he completely ignored it. He didn't respond back to us. And just yesterday on, you know, April, you know, 18th or 17th, he texts back with a price, condition, you know, I'm ready to sell. Let's talk about it. You know, that message was sitting on his phone for months, you know, and it cost the investor no extra money, you know, to continue to market to that lead. And the prospect got back when they were ready. So, you know, if that just really shows our philosophy with the text messaging.
Very, very cool. And obviously, folks, if you don't see it in the upper left-hand corner, we're at simplyleads.net. Again, .net there. So if somebody's watching this and they're not sure this is right for them, what should they do? Should they still reach out? What do you want them to do?
Definitely. Yeah. So, you know, we've got on the website here, as you can see, you know, an AI chatbot that is, you know, loaded and trained with information specifically about our company. So any questions that they have, you know, whether it's, you know, what do you do? How do I get started? Is this a good fit for me?
How do you protect me?
Answer. Yeah. All those questions.
Yeah. Again, folks. Yeah. This is an area where, again, you can get in trouble. So again, asking those questions, feeling protected is the right way to go. If you are generating lists and you don't have the extra time, this could really help you. I think it's worth it. I mean, you're watching this, you're going to know if this is a tool for you. Picks and shovels are how you really get going, right? It's getting the list is important, knowing the target, working with somebody that does this. And again, could you go through to the three-step process above, Griffin? I like
what you had there.
So again, they can come to the website, simplyleads.net, interact with the chatbot there on the right, or they can feel a little bit more confident, or after the chatbot, schedule a meeting. Just, hey, and that'll be 15, 20 minutes, maybe a fit, maybe not a fit, but they'll know at the end of that, yes or no, right? That's the idea.
Right. And you could do something as simple as.
Oh, okay. Look at you.
Ask the chatbot directly.
Okay.
And then it's going to get back. It's going to send the Calendly link for you to directly click on it. It lets us know, you know, when you'd like a meeting. And then you're able to, you know, speak back to us. And
look at that.
Right. So it'll ask how, you know, how you heard about us.
Yeah. One rental at a time, or ORAT, ORAAT. There you go. Let them know their time's valuable. That's good. Nice.
And so this is a great way, you know, we also have a contact us section at the very top as well, you know, for you to go directly. We'll open that up in a new tab too.
Oh, Michael Super. Oh, that's great. That's funny. Gotta love AI.
Right.
Oh, look at that.
And so directly here, you know, my cell phone, Stone's cell phone, and both of our emails open for, you know, a call, a text, an email at any time of the day. Okay. This contact us form will send an email directly to both of us with, you know, your name and a little bit of information with you if you want us to be the ones reaching out to you. Okay. And it's as easy as that. Yeah. And just in 10 or 15 minutes on a quick little chat, you know, we can get your goals down. We can kind of explain more about what we do and see if it's a good fit.
Yeah. So again, folks, if we go back and I kind of replay what I've heard over the last couple of years, like we talk about PropStream on this channel a few times. It's really about building a list. We've talked about building lists for, you know, purchases in the last 2 years, right? Maybe FHA purchases low down. Maybe there's some creative financing there. We talk about commercial, maybe the small multis like April Crossley, getting private money. There's lots of ways that we can use the data sets that are out there. But until you have the picks and shovels to execute on that data set, it's kind of a heavy lift. And, you know, given what you guys have told me, you're investing in making it sure you protect people, which is good. Mm-hmm. If guys want to use this and they already have lists, I think they should at least check you out, see what's what, see if there's a fit. What is the preferred way? Is it the contact? Is it the chat bot? How do you want them to reach out? What's the preferred?
Well, so we've made it so that they all sort of funnel to the same thing. So whether you give us a call directly, whether you have the chat bot, you know, give the calendar link, or you fill out the contact us page, all of it will funnel into, you know, a one-on-one meeting directly with us to talk more about it. So
awesome.
Yeah.
Well, folks, do me a favor. If this is of interest to you, reach out to them. Let's see how they do. Give me feedback. Love to hear what's going on with Simply Leads. I think you have something. As long as you are investing in protecting folks, which you are, you've already highlighted that early in the show. I think that's pretty cool. So let's see if anybody at One Rinse a Lot of Time reaches out. And I love to get the stories either way, if it's worked or if it hasn't. So Griffin Stone, any kind of closing thoughts?
Well, no, really, you kind of covered it. You know, any investor who, you know, whether you are, you know, looking to pull your list and start your journey, or like you said, if you've got lists already that maybe you've gone through with a cold caller or you've sent mail to, you know, and you really want to bring in another marketing stream, another stream of qualified warm leads for you to touch, you know, we're going to be the service for you. You know, we want to kind of tailor ourselves around being the lead generation service for, you know, not just, you know, any investor, but all investors, right? The modern investor who wants to sort of, you know, take their lead generation to the next step and sort of overcome a lot of the barriers that we talked about with traditional cold calling and other traditional marketing. So
very, very cool, folks. I look forward to, oh, go ahead, Stone. Sorry.
I was just going to say, yeah, just to kind of jump off that a little bit, you know, we do this for any type of property as well, whether you're looking for, you know, small single family stuff all the way up to multi-billion dollar commercial buildings. We've used everything in between, mobile home parks, all that stuff. It works well for it. So, you know, if you guys are investing in that, we'd love to talk to you.
Awesome. I appreciate that. Well, Stone, Griffin, thank you for all you do. I look forward to hearing from the One Rental at a Time family. Take care of yourself. Have a wonderful day.
Thanks. You too, Michael. Appreciate having us on.
You got it.